Joining me now for more analysis on today's developments is Emad Kiyaei, the executive director of the American Iranian Council, a nonprofit educational organization. He's also a researcher at Princeton University. How significant is what happened today?
First of all, thank you for having me. This is a major breakthrough. It is very significant on two accounts. We first of all have this return of Iranian Americans who were held in jail in Iran, and of course, vice versa in United States. Of course, the latest announcement of the IAEA bringing in, ushering in the implementation day for a nuclear deal. So a very good day for the Iranians and for the international community as a whole.
Right, so there were kind of two tracks, as Secretary Kerry mentioned. One, the prisoner swap or humanitarian gesture, whatever you want to call it, and then the Iranian deal itself.
Yes.
And really, he said that these things merged and were accelerated because the relationships between him and Zarif were getting stronger over the 2.5 years that they worked together.
Oh, I totally agree with his assessment, especially because if you look at the 2.5 years of negotiations, they were not only just intense. For the first time, United States and Iran engaged directly with one another after 36 years of marred relations. So you have a direct channel between Iran and the United States. And of course, that helped in this case and in previous cases. In this past 100 hours, we have seen, even with the case of the Marines, the Navy, the 10 sailors who were released within 24 hours. This also came about because of the good relationship between Secretary John Kerry and his counterpart, Javad Zarif.
And they could have been used as pawns in a much longer chess game, right?
This would never happen 2.5 years ago, even a year ago, especially when the Revolutionary Guard itself had taken these sailors captive.
So tell me, does this change the international community's perception of Iran like Iran wants it to be? They want to be at the stage. They want to be engaged in trade with the world.
Well, this is how the current President Rouhani came into power, on the bank of trying to remove Iran's isolation from the international community, resolve the nuclear issue, and of course, revamp the Iranian economy that has been under so much pressure because of the sanctions. So yes, Iran wants to rejoin the international community and more robustly than before. And I think that this image of Iran, this trend is going in the right direction to bring about a new assessment from the American side on who they're dealing with in the Iranian leadership. And I hope that this nuclear deal, the prison exchange swap, and the release of the sailors is just one step towards opening up the relationship between two countries on more pressing issues that they see eye to eye. May that be the security and stability in Afghanistan, in Iraq, the fight against ISIS, even Syria, Yemen, and energy security. So there's a lot at stake here and a lot on the table that they can still discuss.
And what about the issues inside Iranian society that we as Americans would still have serious problems with?
Well, I mean, depends on which ones. I mean, domestic issues. Mm-hmm. Obviously, in my opinion, the isolation of Iran did not help the human rights conditions of Iranians within the country. I believe through engagement, through diplomacy, and through opening up of Iran and engaging it with the international community, we will see also within the country a more space for civil liberties, for human rights conditions to improve. And when we closed off a country, obviously this becomes a much more difficult to press a country to evolve or change its position on very, you know, such matters as you mentioned in the country.
All right, Emad Kiyaei, thanks so much for joining us.
It's been a pleasure.